Good morning. What a wonderful day we have. What a wonderful day and a beautiful day the Lord has given us. It seems appropriate that we are here on a farm called God's Gift Farm. Because not only does this remind us through the beauty of God's creation, of His power and His love, but it also reminds us that marriage itself is a gift from God. We're grateful to each one of you for joining with us today and to be a part of this wonderful celebration. Rachel, you're looking stunning. Jeremy, you're Jeremy. This may be the only time you will see both of us in one place in a suit. As a matter of fact, as I look at all these good-looking fellas, I'm thinking, fellas, it's time for a warning. 33 years ago, I looked like you guys. And ladies, as beautiful as you are, 33 years ago, my wife looked as beautiful as you. And she still does.
Good save.
Weird. I didn't know how to catch myself. What a joy it is to be together and to celebrate the union of Jeremy and Rachel. This is a special day for them, but also for us who love them. And so we're glad that you are all here to be a part of their special day. We come to bring them together in holy matrimony. But we do this before the Lord. Marriage was instituted by God in the beginning of time. He brought a man and a woman together and said to the man, you shall, and to the woman, you shall leave your parents, you shall come together, and you will be one flesh. That speaks certainly of intimacy, but so much more. And so today we celebrate that union. As a matter of fact, the first recorded miracle that Jesus did was a miracle you may remember at a wedding feast. And so we celebrate in a similar way a wedding today. But because it's so important and it's more than a formality, it's a covenant being made between Jeremy and Rachel today before witnesses and before God. And so as we enter into this holy covenant, we're reminded to take it seriously, to not enter in unadvisedly, but with sobriety and carefulness. This is an important day. Because of all those things and because it matters to God, I think it is only right that we would begin our time with prayer. So please bow your heads and we commit this day to the Lord. Father, we are indeed grateful for the beauty of this day and the reminder of your power and your care. We're grateful for this couple. As they come together as one, they put on display their love for one another, but more importantly, their love for you. And so, Father, we pray that today would be a celebration of their relationship coming together as husband and wife, but also we come together today to honor and to put on display your love for your people. Scripture is very clear that you're the bridegroom and that your people are your bride. And so right from the get-go, we understand that something is being put on display today for your glory. We pray that we would honor this couple, but more importantly, we would see the focus on you. So we give our day to you, grateful for the weather, grateful for friends and family, grateful for the display of the glorious gospel, and grateful for Jeremy and Rachel. We love them so much, Lord, and we pray that your blessings would be upon our time. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Amen.
So now the very difficult part, Dad. Who gives this young lady to this man to be married?
Her mother and I, you.
Amen. Amen. Just keep breathing, brother. At this time, we're going to do something that is called a declaration of intent. This is a statement or a declaration of marriage and a statement of their intent to be together. Jeremy and Rachel, I will read through this, and when I'm done, you will simply respond in the affirmation with I will. So Jeremy, will you have Rachel to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her and comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Amen. Rachel, you have to memorize the same line. Rachel, will you have Jeremy to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, to be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Amen. At this time, we would like to have Abigail come forward and read some scriptures.
be sincere, hate what is evil, cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in brotherly love. Honor one another above yourself. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor, serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share God's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud, but be willing to associate with people of low position. Do not be conceited. Do not repay anyone evil for evil. Be careful to do what is right in the eyes of everybody. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Colossians 3:12-14. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity.
Thank you. Thank you, Abigail. As Rachel and Jeremy listened to those words, these scriptures were part of our time together as we prepared. We often would find ourselves simply looking at the scriptures to look and see what the Lord had for them. But as you all listened today to those verses, if you did not figure out that kind of a marriage, for that matter, that kind of a relationship with one another is impossible. This is why we so much need the Lord's help. Even as they enter into marriage today, into this covenant, we're reminded that every day they will need the Lord's help to love one another and to submit to one another and to surrender their lives to one another. I probably should preface my comments by saying this, that as much as I am here to honor Rachel and Jeremy, as much as we want to spend this day focused on them, I told them in the beginning, before we ever started meeting, that this day was more about God than it was about them. And if that is new to you, we understand. That doesn't sound like it makes sense, does it? This is indeed their special day. But this special day is as important as it is for Jeremy and Rachel. This special day is about the Lord himself. As they come together to show the start of their relationship together in this covenant that they enter as husband and wife, their intention is very much so to put on display the glory of God in his love for the church, his bride. So I say all that to make sure I did not first and foremost come to make everybody happy today, although it is a joyous occasion, and although I really love this couple with all my heart and have grown to love them more as we spent a lot of time together, and one of them takes a lot more loving to get used to, and you wouldn't have to look around. Nobody knew who I was talking about. I love both of them dearly. We spent a lot of time together. I've asked them to do a lot of hard things over the last year, to spend a lot of time listening and learning and reading. I asked them to read a book or two. I asked them to spend time in scripture. I asked them to... You want me to rush along, don't you? But it's important that you see the development of a relationship, because a marriage founded on anything else but the love of Christ and his model will not be a marriage of happiness. This is about the display case, the glory of God through a marriage. And his love for his people was sacrificial. It was a love that gave up his life. The way to the cross for Christ is demonstrated in a marriage and in all relationships, as our way of life is also a life towards the cross, meaning we give up our preferences and what matters to me most to put somebody ahead of us, to love somebody more than ourselves in a sense, to care and to protect for one another. And if the passage in the Bible that is most often used for marriages comes from Ephesians chapter 5, verses 21 to 33. While I not read all of that, I will simply let you know that there's a couple of principles that Jeremy and Rachel have decided to build their marriage upon. First, Ephesians 5:21 talks about mutual submission to one another. Jeremy says to Rachel, I love you, I will put you first. Apart from my love for the Lord, my love for you will be the most important thing in my life. I will take your preferences, not my own, and vice versa, and Rachel will do the same. That is what we mean by denying ourselves and submitting to one another. There's another part of that passage that also speaks to the man specifically when it says that he will love his wife. Jeremy will love Rachel the way Christ loves his church. As I just described, that was a sacrificial, life-giving love, and Jeremy is called to love Rachel that way. It's interesting, in that passage, there's two things that make everybody a little bit uncomfortable. The wife is called to submit to the husband, and so we immediately raise our arms and say, well, that cannot be in this century. That's not how it goes in this culture. And hence, look where our culture is. But the God way for mutual submission of husband to wife and wife to husband, yes, indeed, from the scriptures, is the head of the house. That is not tyranny. That is not abuse. If we really got what marriage was all about, we'd realize that any woman would love to be in mutual submission to a man that loved her like the Lord loves his church. But I asked Jeremy, which one of these was tougher? Rachel submitting to Jeremy as husband because he's imperfect, as we all are? Or would it be more difficult for Jeremy to love Rachel as the Lord loved the church? They were both impossible. But you could almost argue that for Jeremy, in that passage called to love Rachel, the way the Lord loves us, that seems like an overwhelming task. And yet that is not only the task of marriage, but the task of all relationships. We could certainly say that each one of them is called to submit to one another. Each one of them is called to love each other as Christ loved the church. But please don't miss what happens next in Ephesians. It then says that the marriage, in this case between Rachel and Jeremy, that the marriage is a mystery. The mystery is not about Jeremy and Rachel. The marriage is about the Lord himself, and he aims to make himself known through this union. He brings this couple together, and as they display the image of God in their lives, they put the image of God on display to their family and friends. And in case you all didn't know it, we do that imperfectly. But this is a starting point of a relationship together to live that way, to love that way, to honor him that way, with his help. And in that way, we do indeed make his name famous. So Jeremy, Rachel, it has been my privilege to walk with you guys and to see you grow over the last year. Rachel, you are beautiful in every way. Just as a pastor, you mean so much to our church. You make a difference and have for a long time. I could say more, but I've got a time limit. But then there's Jeremy. And over the last 2 years, we've had a chance to become buddies and friends. And I love this guy with all of my heart. As a matter of fact, the challenges that he faces and the difficulties that he has, just like all of us. But in particular, some of the things that Jeremy goes through, has been through, and you know, still deals with, we'll say, I can relate to. And so when I look at this guy, I see myself many years ago. How many years ago is not important. But I see myself in him, and I just can't tell you how much I've seen the Lord work in his life. He's got 70 or 80 or more years, hopefully, to work that out. We are all works in progress. But to see this couple overcome some real battles and get to here today is a tribute to the faithfulness of the Lord. This is an amazing picture. And what we're going to do now is we're going to ask them to participate in what is called, you may know, as a sand ceremony. And they're going to come back to the sand table, and they're going to share the sand into from 2 to 1. And it's a picture of the union of a husband and a wife coming together. It's a picture of their lives being melded into one for the glory of God. But more than that, is a picture of what happens when a person becomes a Christian. Through repentance of sins, the gospel is that Christ has come to give new life to anyone who calls upon him in repentance and faith. There is an alienation between us and God, and Christ comes to make that way available. We cry out to him as our Savior, our Lord, in repentance of our sins and
come to him and follow him and deny ourselves and live like him. And in this ceremony of the sand, as they put the sand together, you're going to see these two lives come together. But don't miss the beautiful picture of how the Lord brings us together and we become one with Christ through our conversion and repentance and faith. So watch as this beautiful moment of marriage and union is dramatized in the sand ceremony. Thank you, Rachel and Jeremy, for the beautiful picture of what the Lord does in our hearts. One more word in closing from this part of our time together is that this marriage that Rachel and Jeremy embark upon today is more than the contract that I signed to make this official as the pastor. This is more than a legal contract. This is a covenant between two parties. It's a covenant intended to last for a lifetime. But it's also temporary in the sense that when we get to heaven, this life ends and we come home. We are citizens of a different kingdom. And so we live every day together, loving one another as we display the love of the Lord, knowing that our ultimate home is when we get to heaven and spend eternity with him. These are some of the pictures we see as he poured the sand into the box. What a beautiful picture. Thank you. Now we come, guys, to a chance where you get to express your vows to one another, and this does require some paying attention, because you're going to repeat after me. I promised Jeremy I would keep it to 12 words. Just repeat after me. I, Jeremy, take you, Rachel, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge you my love and faithfulness. Amen. Rachel, you got it right. I, Rachel, take you, Jeremy, my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge to you my love and faithfulness. Amen. At this time, we have the privilege of the exchange of rings.
Problem.
Oh my God.
What is
a joke, right?
Aww.
Oh, look.
There's the ring.
See.
From the wings of the family.
My goodness. Is this the greatest ring delivery you've ever seen?
That bird was here.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit,
and of the Holy Spirit.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
Symbol of my love.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
All that I have.
I honor you. In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And the Holy Spirit. At this time, I would like to invite the parents up. As we gather around Jeremy and Rachel, we will have a time of prayer with the family. Gather around in the circle. Moms, dads, if anybody would like to say short prayers, and then I will close us. Father, we have come today to celebrate Rachel and Jeremy, but we've also come to celebrate you. Father, what a precious moment now to have parents here surrounding their kids with prayer. Father, we're giving them to you. We pray that you would do your work in each of their hearts to make them more like you. As they grow closer to you, they will come closer to each other. We pray, Father, for each one here today that has witnessed this celebration and this covenant ceremony. We pray that it will be a reaffirmation for couples, for those that may be in difficult places. May they be reminded of the power that you have been willing to give for those that trust you. So, Father, now we continue our celebration, giving you all the praise for what we've done, what we're doing, and what will come the rest of this day. And we pray that you would be honored. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Parents, you can have a seat. So, Jeremy and Rachel, by the power invested in me by the state, but more importantly, by the power invested in me by the Lord himself as a minister of the gospel, it is my great privilege and joy to pronounce you as husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Woo! now my privilege, for the first time in public, to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jeremy Mitchie.
Yeah.